Most people dream of being rock stars, of having fame, fortune, and money. As the saying goes, though, be careful what you wish for. Such were the feelings of Roger Waters after the success of Dark Side of the Moon, when he penned the heavy critique of the record industry with Have a Cigar. After Dark Side of the Moon became a massive critical and commercial success, Pink Floyd's record label expected a follow-up of equal or greater success. The same people that had been so dismissive and critical of the group in the past were now so happy they could hardly count. Waters viewed the industry as cold, unfeeling, and money-hungry, not concerned with the artistic process and instead the bottom line. How much could they get out of an artist before they were used up? In many ways, he gave the company what they wanted. They wanted something on par with the previous single, Money, and so he created a sequel, dealing with many of the same themes. The band began working on the track off and on between January and July of 1975 at Abbey Road Studios. Both Waters and David Gilmour would record vocals for the track, but neither were happy with the results, although both would share vocals during the In the Flesh tour. Recording in Abbey Road as well was Roy Harper, who was asked to come in and do a take that ultimately ended up on the record. Gilmour would call Harper's take the perfect version. Waters didn't care for it, saying it sounded too much like a parody. It would be released as a single in the United States and European markets, with the United States B-side being Welcome to the Machine and the European B-side being Shine On You Crazy Diamond Part 1. Probably the most famous lyric is, "By the way, which one's pink?" something that regularly happened to the band. Speaking on its origin, David Gilmour said, "We did have people who would say to us, 'Which one's pink?' and stuff like that. There was an awful lot of people who thought Pink Floyd was the name of the lead singer, and that was Pink himself and the band. That's how it all came about." It was quite genuine. So what do you think about this song? Where do you think it rates in the lexicon of all the work of Pink Floyd? Let me know in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching. Please leave a comment, like, share, subscribe, watch my old videos, and thank you so much for watching. I will see you guys next time.